Hello everyone, myself Parth.
Can I ask you a question first? Have you all enrolled for the IIT Bombay X system? For the student system where you are getting your quizzes and assignments? So I think I might deliver you a good news, because I and my team have developed a system which, when you enroll for a course in the IIT Bombay X system, you will get the assignments and quizzes which will definitely weight some marks, and these marks will be automatically considered in your university. So it is definitely a positive point for you and your universities that your universities will be getting all your grades and assignments from our system IIT Bombay X. There is a very good saying that we need to bring learning to people instead of people to learning, because if we consider 100 students, then approximately 90 students in a class are not listening, they are just hearing, and the rest of the 10% are actually listening. So in a survey we have found that the 90% students that are not listening or that are thinking outside of the class, so we want to have their participation and active learning. So we have and as well as the teachers who are the teachers have no idea that the students are not having active participation. These are different types of users interacting with our system, that is IIT Bombay blended MOOCs for consortium, and these are the modules we have developed, that is the registration module, login module, course management module, team management module, and student information management module. Then after that Dheeraj will guide you to the registration process.
Good afternoon everyone, I'm Dheeraj. Okay, so this is an entry point, I mean the gate to enter into our system, the registration process. There are two ways of getting a person registered to our system. Okay, one is through a request register and another one is through an invitation. Now the request for registration, if a user wants to register into our system, he will fill up a request registration form, and that request will be sent to the higher authorities, and the authorities will accept or decline their request, and according to that they can register. Another one is through an invitation. Okay, I will explain you both the processes separately. Yeah, so this is a request registration process. Firstly, the user fills the request for registration form. Afterwards, a self-verification of email link is sent to the user. Okay, that is to verify that the email he has entered is proper or not. After that, when he has successfully verified his email, a request is sent to the higher authorities. All the authorities, suppose I am requesting for a program coordinator, so the higher authority will be a HOI. So the HOI will get a request that, okay, I have requested for this particular role. So now the authority's decision. Suppose say that the authority has accepted my request, okay? So after the acceptance of the request, a personalized registration link will be sent to the user. Okay, now this registration form will be will get open after clicking on this link. This will be a personalized registration form, so he cannot change the email and the institute selected, because this has been accepted by authority. Okay, so after a user fills the registration form, he can is successfully registered. Suppose the authority decision, he has declined the request. So the user can request for some other role, or same role in some other institute, or same role for some other course in some other institute again after. So the similar process will repeat. Next is the registered through invitation process. The authority sends an invitation to a person through his or her dashboard that we'll be explaining later. After sending a request, first of all, user validation will be checked, that particular user already exists in our system or not. If the user already exists, we need not again register him. We can directly update his role. Okay, so yeah, if the user already exists, an email is sent to him having two links. One is the consent link and another one is the dissent link. So now the invitee has the authority that, okay, I want this role, okay, I accept it. So after clicking on the consent link, he has successfully accepted his invitation and his particular profile gets updated with that role, with that course. Suppose that particular user don't want to accept this. So the invitation is rejected by clicking on the dissent link, and the email will be sent to the authority that, okay, the invitee has rejected your invitation. Next one, suppose the invitee is a fresh user. So again, the similar process, a personalized registration link will be sent to the user. User clicks on that, he fills the registration form, and after that, he is successfully registered into our system. So in these two ways, registration can be done. Okay, next, the login will be.
This is just a simple login page that we have in normal websites. So you can just see login. If it is valid, then you go to the home page. If it is not valid, if it is not valid, then you are again redirected to the home page. It's just a simple login page for our website. Next, he'll continue.
So main aim of this project is to teach students. So to teach students, courses are must. They take courses and they get information about those courses. So we have course management module. It has five features. View current courses, that is the courses which is the institute is currently enrolled in. Find courses, if the institute wants to enroll in further new courses. Participate in a course, that is if he found a course interesting, he can participate in the course. Update details of a course. If he wants to change the details which he has filled while enrolling the course, he can update the details and cancel participation in a course if he wants to cancel the participation in a particular course. So this is basically the flow how course management is done. So a user logs in, and on the basis of the role, that is head or the program coordinator or the course coordinator or the teacher, on the basis of the role, different things happen. Say if the user is head or program coordinator, his home screen appears which shows the current courses in which the institute is currently enrolled. So he can find new courses to enroll. He can enroll in a new course, update the course details, and he can cancel. And at any time, he can log out. He can log out at any time. Now, if the user is course coordinator or the teacher, his home screen appears, which shows only those courses which are under him. The course coordinator has some courses under him. Similarly, the teachers teach some courses, not all the courses of the institute. So they will view only those courses which are under him or her. So they can update the details of their own courses, not all the courses, and of course they can log out at any time. They don't have luxury to enroll for a new course for the institute or cancel for an enrolled course. So this whole module was course management module. Another module is the IIT Bombay X blended MOOC system team. So we want to have a team which keeps an eye or keeps a vigil over everything which happens over this system. So it has three people: report administrator, blended MOOC coordinator, IIT Bombay X course faculty. So three parts, I will explain one by one. IIT Bombay X reports admin. So this person has the luxury to view all the reports, any kind of reports related to the system. So he chooses a report to view, and the view he can view the report. In the next screen, the report appears. None other is IIT Bombay X blended MOOCs coordinator. Now his role is that he can select any institute from the approved list of institute. He can select the roles which are present in that particular institute, and on the basis of the institute he selected, the role he selected, he gets into the system for that institute on the basis of that role. The last one is IIT Bombay X course faculty admin. So this person at IIT Bombay X can know the performance reports of students which are enrolled in IIT Bombay X system. So he selects the course for which he wants to know the details, for which he wants to know the performance. He selects the report and he can view the report.
I have a question. Now, IIT Bombay X faculty, they have logged in IIT Bombay X. They can view the grades of students over there. So what is the difference in your report, course faculty report? IIT Bombay X course faculty, you have given a login to them. So they can view the grades in the IIT Bombay X. So what is the difference in your system? What kind of reports they can view?
This report shows the average marks scored in each quiz by all the students of the institute. So the admin can compare the performance of all the institutes and can take necessary actions, whether he can inform your students are not active or such.
Which kind of grading scheme you are using?
Sir, we are not using any kind of grading scheme. We are receiving the grades from the API provided by Aparna Ma'am's team.
Hi everyone, I am Apurva Agrawal and team management is my module. I'll cut straight to the point. Right now we are offering 4 different roles to every participating institute: head of the institute, program coordinator, course coordinator and the teacher. So as the student, as the institute enrolls for more and more courses, the last two roles will keep on increasing. So the institute will find that it has a large number of people to manage, and that is where team management comes in. The 4 roles we are offering will have this hierarchy. The head of institute is at the top, and that is why he has the authority over all of these. It is actually a tick. So he has the authority over all of them. Coming to the teacher, he does not have any authority over any other role except for students. So the basic functionality of team management is divided into 2 parts: view team, manage team. The view team, we can divide the viewing of the team into 2 parts. First of all is the entire team. The head of the institute and the program coordinator should be able to view all the people who he is working with, irrespective of which course they are working on. But as far as the course team is concerned, somebody who is enrolled for only CS11 should not be able to see all the people who are working on ME209. Manage team. The functionality of manage team is being offered by 3 main tasks. Invitation, adding the members through invitation. Second is approval, disapproval from a request list. Third is update or removal.
So how exactly it works? Suppose there is a one faculty who is teaching a subject or who is coordinating the things, and then in between the faculty changes, let's say for example transfer or leave the job or whatever. So whether it is possible that you can map multiple teacher, that too in between the semester. This is very practical case.
Yes sir. So this is the last thing is update is exactly for that only. Supposingly a person leaves in between, so what we can do is we can finish his tenure at that time and we can appoint somebody else at his role. And as far as the teacher is concerned, we can have multiple teachers for the same role, for the same course. So I don't think that's a problem. If a course coordinator leaves, then we can appoint another one for that.
Whether there is, in most of the cases, there is a clear-cut division. Division in the sense that the few units will be taught by X person and few part of the syllabus can be taught by other person. Suppose that is directly correlated with the grading or valuation or something kind of thing, or whether there is any boundary or the fencing level changes here and there makes any change in your
sir backend. The evaluation is independent of which teacher you are currently starting on. The job of the teacher at maximum is to upload the details of the student. Basically the teacher is responsible for uploading the data of the students.
Many times there is again a possibility. Let's say for example physics is common for the first year in so many institute. Okay, so one person teaches only first unit to 6 different sections, and then the other person teaches the unit number 2 to all. So how exactly you cater to this?
So I have already asked about the updation. First was invitation. A person in authority can invite somebody he thinks is good enough for a particular role. Supposingly a head of the institute thinks that particular person Subrata Joy, he can invite him by sending him an email. He will just write his name and email, and a link will be sent to him, sent to that email asking him to register. If he registers, he will be automatically promoted to that role. So it basically works on now you can only have one person at a role at one time. If somebody is there, you'll have to either remove it or cancel his invitation to continue. Second is request user list. Although right now we are supporting an authority can invite somebody, but it is equally good that somebody can also request the higher authority that let's say I want to become a course coordinator. He can fill a request registration form as described by Dheeraj, and the request will go to higher authorities. It will be available on the dashboard. He can either approve or disapprove. The proper details will be available. So if he approves a link will be sent back to the invitee, requestee, to register, and a cancellation will send a similar mail.
Hello everyone, good afternoon. My name is Mohsin Mohammed and I have worked on the student data management module. So basically it deals with the student data information provided by the blended MOOCs partners who institutes who are participating in the our initiation, the Dr. Pathak's initiation for the blended MOOC. So this module deals with the student data and it provides the facility to deals with the student data, but in a restrictive manner. We have the two types of hierarchy in student data management module. First one is the teacher, which is the lower hierarchy, and second one is the higher authorities, where we have the course coordinator, program coordinator, and the head of institution. So in the student data management module, we have five types of functionalities. First, the show student details, and second one is the add students, upload student information, unenrollment, and substitute teacher. So first of all, show student details.
I'm surprised you didn't have anything to group the student. How the student can be grouped together? Suppose there are students in the class, they can have elective subjects. So few students will be grouped with the one X elective and Y elective, although they are the part of the same class. So how, there is no provision I have seen that you can group the student in particular pocket.
This is a future work, sir. In our blended MOOC, we have
future. It is a mandatory condition. If you go to any academic MOOC system, you will find the electives are the part of the syllabuses. So how the electives can be addressed then?
Sir, but actually in the blended MOOC, for each classroom we have only one teacher for one course. There is not. If the elective
is another course, right? But in the one class, you have got, just go to the previous slide, you have got the add student, upload student kind of thing, and then the substitute teacher, right? So the in the one class, if there are 50 students available, they necessarily being grouped into the different group based on their own elective, right? So the grouping the student, I didn't find any provision at this fair.
You have not given a broader picture of your system, that's the problem. When you said HOI, nobody actually knows what is HOI. Sir, and then after some time, you showed HOI.
The thing
sir,
time limit constraints.
Oh, there's no time limit. So the thing is that what we are doing is that when we will run this blended MOOCs program, then the institute will be using the grades of MOOCs for their students over there. So they have to view the grades. So there are two parts to it. One is that they have to mark their students, that these are the students of this course who are participating in this blended MOOCs program, and second is to view their grades. So in order to do that, they have built a process in which, for example, the head of the institute, he should be able to view the data of all the students belonging to all the courses. Then the head can delegate that thing to a program coordinator. So normally there will be a program coordinator who will be handling everything. Each course, like we saw the data, that CS101 is taught across the first year students, so there are multiple teachers. So we created a course coordinator role, CS101 coordinator of say VNIT, saying that he will be responsible for the entire set of CS101. This is more to do with the management with IIT Bombay X team, bridge kind of thing. And the actual teachers who are teaching the course become the teachers over here. So they do the actual thing. They mark, they upload the students' information over here, saying that these are the students. What they do is that they will, when I become the teacher of CS101, for example, I will write an email to all my students, or I will announce to my students that please register on IIT Bombay X and enroll for CS101 course. Then I will float an Excel saying that please fill in your user registered username and email of IIT Bombay X and along with roll number. This information is stored in this system and by me as a teacher, and that is available over here. This system, the system that they have built, will validate whether that username and the email address is correct, whether they have actually enrolled, and they give that information to the teacher. Second thing is, when the course starts, CS101, there will be quizzes every week. So that performance data is visible to me as a teacher, to course coordinator, the entire student group, and to the head, all the courses, blended MOOCs courses, they have participated. So what they have done is they have divided them into basically five modules to make development easy and make it easy for everybody. There's a registration module. Right now for this semester, we are going to bypass it because we already have collected the information. After the 6 June meeting, we have started collecting the information and we will directly register them. And there's a course management module. Basically, in next semester, if we float four courses, then an institute head and the program coordinator can decide which institutes he wants to participate. So there's a course enrollment page. You can cancel the enrollment. You can update the cancellation. Then comes the team management, because now first time we are doing the registration. Next time we say you register. So you can invite your faculty members on various roles. And this is the main thing where they actually upload the student's data. So when the teacher has collected that Excel file, he saves it in CSV and he can upload it over here. So we have created a template, we have given a sample CSV for the teacher to view.
So institute level user will get the option to upload the students or to add student list. So what we have done is we have provided the upload CSV functionality. So he has to browse a file from his system. So a CSV file will be uploaded, and when he click on the upload CSV, then an upload report will be generated. For each record, we have a required message. We have done the all kind of validations. So the username and email should be same as the user provided on the IITBX site, because it is the same integrated course which is running on the other institute also. So if the username and email is valid, then we show the message that successful, or the suppose like the username is invalid, so we have send a message that the user not found or student already exists. Well, student already exists means teacher is wants to again upload a CSV with the same record. So we are giving a message that this student is already exists. Then there are two links to download the valid student records and invalid student records. So he can download the invalid records and edit in the same CSV. So he don't need to create the another CSV.
Sir, initially we are getting a mail list or CSV.
Which contains all the details of institutes and their corresponding persons, that is the head of the institute and everything. And after that, we have wrote a Python script that will load the CSV file into our database. And after that, an invitation, personalized invitation link will be generated on which if you click, a registration page will be displayed for the person only, that person only. The person then fills up the form.
So this is a personalized email registration form, so you can't edit the email as it has been approved by some higher authorities.
Sir, this is a customized logging page, and this is a teacher home in which a teacher can upload the student, or he can view the student details and view a report. First, a student will upload the teacher will upload the students. If a teacher doesn't know what is the format of the CSV, there is a sample CSV file. If we download it, the student will know in which format he has to upload the student details. This is the format of the student sample CSV. That is, the first name is the roll number, username and email ID. After that, he will click on upload.
The same thing as I have explained before. So he will get a upload report after the uploaded CSV. So the message success means the student is successfully added under his guidance, and the student not enrolled means he has not he has registered on the IIT Bombay but he has not enrolled for the course. Suppose the course is CS101, so he is not enrolled yet. So he can download the valid and invalid records, so he can edit in the same files and upload it again. This is the record and the view reports, where a teacher can show the details of the student performance according to the quiz wise and the grade, and if for each and every entry, his quizzes and the average marks. He can download the same CSV.
So this is course management. So now course is fine. He wants to enroll for this thermodynamics course. He can see the details of the course. Course is starting, course grade criteria, grade policy and all that. And he clicks on the participation of this course. Now form appears which he needs to fill, all the details like the starting date, end date of his own institute, corresponding course name, etc., etc. And he clicks enrolls. So he will get this on-screen display that yes, you have successfully enrolled, and he gets two options, that you want to manage team for this course or you will do it later. So if say yes, so team management module appears.